स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर वन, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल. नाउ ऑल ऑफ यू नो योर आईटी सब्जेक्ट, देयर आर टू पार्ट, वन इज एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल एंड अनदर इज वोकेशनल स्किल. दिस कम्युनिकेशन स्किल चैप्टर्स आर अंडर इन योर एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट हियर दिस सेशन. आई विल राइट मेथड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. Method means how many types of communication. Before I'll explain what are the methods of communication, first all of you know what is communication skill. Now communication skill means sending or receiving information, or you can say in this way exchange of your thoughts or share your views or ideas. This is called communication. Now there are three types of basic communication skill are there. One is verbal communication, non-verbal communication and visual communication. Now what is verbal communication? Verbal communication means if you share your thoughts, share your information using words or using sentence, that means it is a verbal communication. Most of the time we'll use verbal communication to convey our messages. There are two types of verbal communication, oral communication and written communication. I'll give you a small example of oral communication. Now I am explaining you this chapter, and here I'll use oral communication because I'll share the information orally. Am I right anything here? No. I'll just explain verbally means orally. Now what is the example of written verbal communication? When you'll write the answer in your copy, that means you'll use a written verbal communication. Here I'll explain the classification of verbal communication. Verbal communication are two types, one is oral, another is written. And here the classification of verbal communication is, first is intrapersonal communication. Second is interpersonal communication. This is intra and this is inter. Next is small group communication. And last one is public communication. There are four types of verbal communication. Now what is intrapersonal communication? If you talk with yourself, means with your minds, that means it is a intrapersonal communication. Sometime when you are giving some speech to the audience, you have to prepare the point in your mind, or you will chalk out some point in your mind. That is a intrapersonal communication. But onek shomoy dekhbe tumra jokhon kono kichu audience ke bolar age sob shomoy seta mind e bhabo, ba onek shomoy dekhbe nijei self prepare koro. That means it's a intrapersonal communication. Now what is interpersonal communication? It is a two way process. Means here sender are there, receiver are there. Sender who send the message to the receiver, and receiver receive the message and reply back to the sender. So here both sender and receiver keep swapping their roles. When receiver reply back to the sender, so that in case receiver's role change to the sender's role, and now receiver will be the sender. Talking to a phone is the example of interpersonal communication. Now small group of communication. What is small group of communication? Here I am giving you one example. Sometime you may notice principal sir conducts teachers meeting. In this case, each individual teacher will get an opportunity to say something. So in this small group meeting, when principal sir share his or her views, and also the participant means the teachers also share their views. So when any one of the teacher reply back, then that time teacher is the sender. In this communication, always a specific idea being discussed. Press conference also an example of small group of communication because it is held in a small group. And also in this small group of communication, sender also send the messages and we are the receiver, though it is a group, but we also share our views. Next is public communication. Public communication generally, example, election campaign, in or you can say in workshop or seminar. There are huge crowd or huge audience are there and there is only one speaker. And this speaker address all the audience and share their views. This is called public communication. Public communication সব সময় দেখবে huge groupে হয় আর সেখানে receiverরা generally কিছু বলে না, সব সময় speaker যে sender সেই সব সময় কথা বলবে বা communicate করবে. I hope all of you understand these four types of communication. Intrapersonal means when you speak through your mind or through itself, this is called intrapersonal. Interpersonal means when sender send the message and receiver receive the message and reply back to the senders. Small group of communication, there is a group which is formed and there is a sender also, group of people are there, sender send the message and receiver sometime reply back to the senders. And public communication generally audience are there, huge audience are there. They are not saying anything, only the speaker or the main sender send all the information. Next, effective speaking. Now, when a person choose a correct word or correct sentence for express his or her feeling or sharing information, that is called effective speaking. When you speak effective way, you must choose a correct word or correct sentence. Now here I'll write some point or some tips which you will remember when you will give a speech or if you are an effective speaker. Always start a opening line when you start communication. Suppose if I'll start today's lesson, explain for this slide or just say the method of communication, these and these will be understand and this will be understand. I'll give one simple example. So এটা কি তোমরা বুঝতে পারবে যদি আমি হট করে এই স্লাইড থেকে শুরু করি? না, তোমাকে প্রথম থেকে যদি না বোঝানো হয় যে আজকে আমরা কি পড়ছি বা কি চ্যাপ্টার পড়ব, তাহলে তোমাদের বোঝাটা একটু অসুবিধা হবে. সো ওপেনিং লাইন ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট. নাও আই উইল গিভ ইউ ওয়ান স্মল এক্সাম্পল হিয়ার অলসো. In our annual day, first our anchor address all the gathering. After that, they start the program because we know first impression is a last impression. Now choose your words with care. When you are speaking to the teacher, you will speak in a very formal way. On the other hand, when you will speak with your friends, you will speak in a very casual way. So it depends on the environment, also depend on the situation, and therefore you have to very careful when you choose your words. সব সময় দেখবে যখন তুমি কথা বলো, depend করে যে তুমি কোন এনভায়রনমেন্টে কাদের সাথে কথা বলছো. তুমি যখন টিচারের সাথে কথা বলো একরকম ভাবে কথা বলবে, তুমি যখন স্টুডেন্টদের সাথে কথা বলবে আরেক রকম ভাবে কথা বলবে. তো চুজ ইওর ওয়ার্ডস ভেরি ক্রুশিয়াল. নেক্সট, ক্ল্যারিটি অফ স্পিচ. ইফ দ্য লিসনার ইজ আনএবল টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড what a speaker is saying, then after some time listener lose track of the conversation. If I'll explain this session in a very low volume or if I'll explain this chapter very firstly, I think you are not able to understand properly. So clarity of speech also very important if you are an effective speaker. Next, calm and focus. If you are not focused, if you are not prepared for delivering the lesson or share your information, share your thought, immediately listener will understand and think that you are not a good speaker or think that maybe you are not fully prepared or you are getting tensed. So it is very important you have to focus your study area or focused your knowledge. Next is questioning. Now questioning, when you ask a question to the audience and their reply helps you to assess how much they have understood. If you're delivering the lesson after finished your explanation, if you'll ask a question and student will reply to you, that means you'll understand. No, student will understand this sub topic. If student not saying anything or student say that no ma'am, I'll not understand this topic, so you'll তুমি বুঝে যাবে যে তোমার হয়তো পড়ানোটা ঠিকঠাক হয়নি। Next is summarize. It means after finished your lecture, then shortly you will summarize the lesson. Means gist of the lesson. After finished my explanation, I'll also saying that so today I'll teach this lesson. I hope you'll understand this topic. So this is called summarize the conversation. Now how you'll close your communication? When you'll finished your chapters or finished your lesson or finished your speaking, also you have to use a closing statement. Jate bujhte pare je na tumi ebar tomar speech shesh korcho. Now there is also active listener. Who are active listener? Those who are open mind, those who are not judgmental, also those who are avoid disturbance. If you listen something and your friend still talking or not attended, also in these online classes is going on, now you'll sit for this class and that time your family member continuously talking in your, so you may be distracted. So suggest some other places for the conversation. So if you'll find there is too much noise, so in this way you have the active listener. তো তুমি কি করবে, তুমি কখন অ্যাক্টিভ লিসনার হবে, যখন তুমি সেই ডিস্ট্রাকশনটা পাবে না বা ডিস্টারবেন্স হবে না, তুমি যখন কোনো জাজমেন্টাল হবে না, মানে কোনো পার্টিকুলার যে স্পিকার তার সম্পর্কে তুমি আগে থেকেই থট ভেবে নেবে না যে হ্যাঁ এ ভালো বলবে না বা এ ভালো করে এক্সপ্লেন করবে না। নাও ইট ইজ অলসো ইম্পর্টেন্ট দ্যাট ইউ উইল গেট দ্য ওভারঅল আইডিয়া অফ হোয়াট ইজ বিইং সেড। If you don't know the topic or don't know what the speaker is talking about, then you lose your interest. Suppose today I'll explain this chapter 1. If I'll not prepare, if I'll not making any slide, so I'll not explain properly. So you have to prepare before you'll delivering any lesson, before you'll share any information. Next is non-verbal communication. Now all of you know what is non-verbal communication. All you have read in class 9 also. Non-verbal communication means when you will not use any word, just use in your body language, gesture. That means your method is a non-verbal communication. Means verbally you will not saying anything, just you use some smiley face or handshake or gesture. These are all example of non-verbal communication. So there are some advantage also in non-verbal communication. What are the advantages? Illiterate people also understand non-verbal communication, because here we will not use any word, only use our body language. So all of you understand, if I am happy, so আমি কি করব, স্মাইলি ফেস রাখবো, বা আমি যখন কোনো ক্লাসে ঢুকবো, বা ধরো আমি কারোর সাথে প্রথম দেখা হচ্ছে, আমি হ্যান্ডশেক করছি, তো দিজ অল আর কল নন ভার্বাল কমিউনিকেশন। ইট অলসো বিল্ড আ গুড র্যাপো বিটুইন দ্য সেন্ডার অ্যান্ড রিসিভার। সাপোজ শেকিং হ্যান্ডস ক্যান ইনক্রিজ দ্য কানেক্টিভিটি বিটুইন দিস সেন্ডার অ্যান্ড রিসিভার অলসো। ইট মোস্টলি কস্ট ফ্রি, জেনারেলি আমাদের কোনো মানে অ্যামাউন্ট লাগে না নন ভার্বাল কমিউনিকেশন করার জন্য। Now here you have to maintain some do's and don'ts when you use non-verbal communication. First of all, don't speak with folded hands. Now if you speak in this way, your listener or the audience think that you are close-minded, or lack of confidence are there, or lack of enthusiasm are there in your mind. Next, don't shake your legs. It means you are not fully prepared for delivering your thoughts or delivering your lesson. Don't turn your back on your audience. Means lose interest in what you are saying. If you turn your back and explain something, So audience they say think that you are not interested to express these lessons or express this information. Don't roll your eyes at the audience. If you use this type of gesture means roll your eyes, तो audience भाभी की you are not confident enough or you are very much shy or you are not fully prepared. Always maintain eye contact. If you delivering a lesson and you will see the floor or the space, so audience think that you are not prepared for delivering your lesson. So eye contact is very important. Also you will check who are listening or not. Wear a smile. It means you have fully of positivity and also gain confidence to the audience. Keep your arms and palms open. Always when you will talk, when you will share a information, keep your arms and palms are open. Walk while you will talk. In class also, when teacher explain the lesson, he or she will, he must be walking from one place to another place. So in this way, he or she monitoring all the students. Now next is visual communication. Now visual communication means when you will see some picture and you will think, oh, this is the picture of this sign. Suppose you will go to airport and you will see there are some signboard are there. Also shopping mall, you will see the signboards of restroom. In mobile also, you will see the pictures of Bluetooth and Wi-Fi and you will know what does the Wi-Fi means. So these are all visual communication. If you will see the picture and understand this picture is meant for this, so these are called visual communication. Example, signboard, logos, traffic signal. These are called visual communication. এখানে তোমাকে কোনো communicate করতে হয় না, তুমি picture দেখেই বুঝে যাবে যে এটা এই picture আর এটার মানে হচ্ছে এটা. Next is public speaking. It means communicating to a large audience. It is also in the last slide I'll explain what is public speaking. There is a audience there and there is only one speaker who delivering the information. These are called public speaking. Now in public speaking you need three P's. One is prepare, another is practice and perform. A tinte is khub important if you are a public speaker. Without these three terms you will not able to a good public speaker. First is prepare. If you are a public speaker, you will deal with so many audience, so you have to prepare with your speech. Always prepare in advance so that in last minute you are not stressed. Here I'll give you one simple example. Amader annual day age anchor ra age theke prepare hoye thake. Jodi tara prepare na hoy তাহলে কি হবে, যেদিন ধরো অ্যানুয়াল ডে সেদিন তারা যদি প্রিপেয়ার না থাকলো তাহলে কি বলবে অডিয়েন্সের সামনে, কারপর কি হবে, কোন ট্র্যাকের পর কোন ট্র্যাক চলবে তারা কিছু বুঝতে পারবে না. তো প্রিপেয়ার ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট. নেক্সট ইজ প্র্যাকটিস. নাও প্র্যাকটিস অলসো ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট. ইফ ইউ নট প্র্যাকটিস ইউর প্রেজেন্টেশন, ইফ ইউ নট প্র্যাকটিস ইউর থটস in the main day, you are not able to share your views properly. In this chapter, if I'll not make any slide, if I'll not share proper information, if I'll not practice myself, am I deliver correctly? No. So practice also very important. Now perform. When you are in front of your audience, just perform for them. যখন তুমি অডিয়েন্সের সামনে পৌঁছে যাবে তখন আর কি ভাববে না যে আমি কিভাবে করব, জাস্ট অডিয়েন্সের জন্য পারফর্ম করবে. তো দিজ আর দ্য মেইন থ্রি পয়েন্টস ইউ হ্যাভ টু রিমেম্বার ইফ ইউ আর আ পাবলিক স্পিকার. সো ইন দিস স্লাইড আই হোপ ইউল আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড হাউ মেনি টাইপস অফ কমিউনিকেশন আর দেয়ার. ওয়ান ইজ ভার্বাল, অ্যানাদার ইজ নন ভার্বাল, অ্যানাদার ইজ ভিজুয়াল. Also, I'll explain what is effective speaker, another is public speaker. So, it is called summarize my slides or summarize my video. In the next video, I'll explain the term feedback.